Hello and welcome to my session of storytelling. I am Dr. Krunal Bua, working as an associate professor in Jamnagar College. Now, we all must have heard stories of Ramayana, Mahabharata, and these are very popular stories. These are very popular ancient Indian mythological history. Now today I would like to present ancient story, mythological story again, but these are little less popular but still have much more impact to understand what is Hinduism and what is ancient history of world, what world was about, how the world has created by Lord Vishnu, Brahmaji, and all this. So let's see, I've tried something new, and from the next slides onwards I'll start explaining or discussing with you the history of mankind. Let's see. As we all know, the earth, mankind history, the earth has been started by the creator Lord Vishnu. He is the creator of this space, we can say this Akash Ganga, different Akash Gangas. Now, as per mythology, Hindu mythology, Lord Vishnu is the creator of this, and Lord Vishnu has created Brahmaji, and he has been asked to Brahmaji to create universe and mankind. Different species on earth, human being, animals, birds, all this what we are seeing right now is created by Brahmaji. So we all are created by God, Lord Brahma, Brahmaji. But when this Brahmaji was planning to create this universe, initially it's really that much a tedious task to create so many animals, birds, species and all this. So Brahmaji has created Prajapatis, or you can say a Manasputra, who can help him in designing the universe, and who can coordinate with Brahmaji. So what it is said is Brahmaji has created the 10 Manasputra. Totally he has created 16 Manasputra, out of which 10 are Prajapatis. I'll explain what is Prajapatis. 4 are Kumars, 1 Kardama Muni, and 1 was one daughter is Satrupa. Satrupa is a girl who is wife of Manu. Manu is the first man on the earth. We also in Hindu we known as Bhagwan Manu. So Satrupa married to Lord Manu, and then the universe or the mankind has been created. So as per mythology, Brahmaji has created 16 Manasputra, out of which 10 were Prajapatis, 4 were Kumars, 1 was Kardama Muni, Kardama Muni you can say, and 1 was Satrupa, who was wife of Manu. And this creation of this mankind, let us first understand who are the Prajapatis, or you can say Manasputra of Brahmaji, and why Prajapati. So Prajapati, Brahmaji need help of this Prajapati, and these are someone who could help him in creation of mankind, or we can say these are the Prajapati who can coordinate with the mankind on earth, that whatever we are because of this Prajapatis. These are the 10 Prajapatis, or you can say 10 Manasputra of Lord Vishnu as per the Hindi mythology. The first was Angiras, second was Atri. Now I also would like to mention these are Prajapatis, Manasputra, and some of these Prajapatis are also Saptrishis. Saptarishis are playing very important vital role in understanding the Vedas. They are the communicator, they are the medium of transferring Ved, Shastra, what Lord has written. And through this Saptarishis, we are gaining the knowledge of that. I'll also discuss in the next part of this video. So these are the names. Second was Atri, third was Pulastya, and there is a link with the Ramayana. In this video, I'll be more explaining, focusing on Pulastya. Then fourth is Marichi, Pulha, Pulaha, you can say. Sixth is Kratu, seven is Brigu, eighth is Vasishth, ninth Narad Muni, he is also Vanasputra of Brahmaji, and the tenth is Chitragupta. So these are the names of Manasputra created by Lord Brahma. As I said, these 10 Manasputra, and some of these Manasputra are also Saptarishis. Now, who are the Saptarishis? These are the names of Saptarishis, and Saptarishis are different in every yug, like Manvantara yug, and then Satyug, Treta, Dwapar. So the green names, these are the current, or you can say, sorry, these are the previous, the first Saptarishis, and this blue are the Saptarishis in the current age. But who are the Saptarishis? Saptarishis are those who are known as seven sages, and who are the medium which God has appointed, or you can say created, through which Purans, Ved, Puran, other important Shastra which God has created, and to explain us how to live life of on earth, what is to be done, what is not to be done, what is right, what is wrong, all this can be explained by Saptarishis. They do it and they explain to us, and these were communicated to the mankinds. So Agastya, Atri, Bhardwaj was Saptarishi, the first the first seven Saptarishis. Gautam, Jamadagni, Vasishth, Vishwamitra was the Saptarishi. He was not Brahmin by birth, but then by doing tapasya and on his own, he became the part of Saptarishis. Now, let us understand what is the link between Saptarishis and Ramayana and other Mahabharata also. So there is a very much popular or very interesting story behind Saptarishis and the link with Ramayana and Mahabharata. So here I am coming up with this Pulastya. There is a link with one of the Saptarishi. Pulastya was one of the Saptarishi, and there is a link with Ramayana. Now, Pulastya is one of the 10 Prajapati also of Manasputra, of Brahmaji. And Prajapati means, as I said in previous part of this video, Brahmaji has created Prajapati who could help him in creation of universe and mankind. And Pulastya is one of the Saptarishis. And Saptarishis are, as I said, the seven sages through which Purans were communicated to the mankind. Now, Pulastya was the first Saptarishi who has got knowledge of Vishnu Puran from his father Brahmaji. So actually, the Vishnu, Lord Vishnu has created Brahmaji, and Brahmaji's son, Manas son, is Pulastya. So Vishnu Puran was first transferred to the mankind from Brahmaji to Pulastya, and Pulastya has made it available to the all mankind. Now Parashara was Mahashri. There was Rishi Parashar. He was Mahashri, and he was author of many ancient texts. Now who is Parashara? He has received this Vishnu Puran knowledge from Pulastya. So there is a link from Vishnu to Brahmaji, from Brahmaji to Pulastya, and from Pulastya to Parashara, and from Parashara to the the human being, or you can say mankind, for the mankind. So Parashara was the Maharshi, and he was author of many ancient texts. Now see, the link with the Saptarishi and the normal mankind, how this Saptarishis are doing hard work for mankind. So Parashara has received the Vishnu Puran from Pulitzer in the present days, and whatever we read, we are reading this Bhagavad Puran, Mahabharat, and these are written by Vedvyas, and actually the Vedvyas is the son of Parashara. So this is how the knowledge of Ved Puran transferred from Lord Vishnu to the us. So from Lord Vishnu to Brahmaji, from Brahmaji to his son, one of the Saptarishi, or you can say Prajapati, Pulatsya, from Pulatsya to Parashara, and from Parashara to Vyas, his son Vyas, that is called Ved Vyas. And we all know knowledge of Ved Vyas, the way he has created Mahabharat. We all are gaining knowledge through Mahabharat. There are a lot of life lessons by hearing Mahabharat, by reading Mahabharat. And all this hard work is done by Ved Vyas. And whatever knowledge of creation Mahabharat, creation of this Mahabharat, is because of his guru. And he has received from Brahmaji and from Vishnu. So this is what the linkages are. Now let's see in the next part of this video, what are the other details, how this Saptarishis are related to Ramayana. Pulatsya Rishi, he was son of Pulatsya was son of Brahmaji, and Vishrava was son of Pulatsya. So Lord Vishnu has created Brahmaji, is from Brahmaji to Pulatsya, Pulatsya to Vishrava, and Vishrava was the brother of Agatsya Muni. So Agatsya Muni and Vishrava both are brother, and ultimately they are grandson of Brahmaji. Vishrava has made tapasya, very hard tapasya, and because of which he has gained lots of knowledge and fame. He has earned enormous amount of knowledge in that time, and many Saptarishis and other rishis were happy with the hard work tapasya done by Vishrava. Now particularly to mention, Rishi Bhadwaj was one of the Saptarishi who was very much happy and proud of Vishrava, and because of this, his happiness, he has given, that means Rishi Bhadwaj has given his daughter named Ilavida, and she has married with Vishrava. So Rishi Bhadwaj was Saptarishi, was very knowledgeable, and he had one daughter. Actually he had four children that I'll discuss in the later part of this video, but his daughter called Ilavida, he had approached Vishrava for the marriage, and they both had marriage. Vishrava and Ilavida had marriage, and they had a son, and his name is Kuber, and we known him as Dhan Kuber. He was very much popular, and we worship him for the wealth. So he is also known as Lord of Wealth, and he was the original king of Sri Lanka. Earlier he was king of Sri Lanka as Vishrava and Ilavida. They were also from that, and they had a son called Kuber. Now Vishrava had two more wives. Ultimately Vishrava had five wives, and he had different children, son and daughter, from different wife, but this was the first, Ilavida. Now let me give a little bit of small brief introduction, small brief detail about Rishi Bhardwaj. Rishi Bhardwaj has four children. First was Ilavida, second was Garga, or you can say Garga, third Katyani, and the fourth is Drona, that we popularly known him as Acharya Drona. Now it is very interesting to understand Acharya Dron was part of Dwapar Yug, and when Lord Shri Krishna has taken birth. Ilavida was part of, you can say, Satyug or Treta Yug, right? And which was almost many lakhs years ago, and when Lord Ram has taken birth, that is avatar of Lord Vishnu. So the question is, Rishi Bhardwaj was, how many years he has there on earth, though he was Saptrishi, but for how many years he has lived? So actually, there is a linkage between Bhardwaj, Rishi Bhardwaj in Satyug, Tretayug, as well as Dwaparyug also. Now, Rishi Bhardwaj was very much interested in gaining knowledge about Ved and Puran. But then it was difficult to complete all these Ved and Puran in his lifespan. So he has worshipped Indra, and Indra got happy with the tapasya of Rishi Bhardwaj, and then he asked Vardhan from Indra that he, that means Rishi Bhardwaj, want three births. Okay, why he wants three births? Because he wanted to complete Ved and Puran, which is very much difficult to complete in just one birth. And that is why during one of the birth which Rishi Bhardwaj has taken, see, in the first birth he had a daughter Ilavida, and Ilavida got married to Vishrava, and Vishrava was having child called Kuber, and Kuber is actually brother of Ravan. So Vishrava is father of Ravan. I'll explain in the later part of this video how there is a link between Kuber and Ravan. But Rishi Bhardwaj, in one of the birth, he has given the Dron is son of Rishi Bhardwaj in one of the jan which is taken by Rishi Bhardwaj. This is what a small part of again, as I said, the Saptrishis have a very good connection with the mankind, and in all yug Saptrishis are some or other way attached. So let's come again story of Vishrava, who was son of Pulatsya, and Pulatsya is Manasputra of Brahmaji. So let us again have a linkage with Vishrava's story. So Vishrava had five wives: Ilavida, as I said, daughter of Rishi Bhardwaj, Kaikasi, Pushpotkata, Malini, and Rakha. Now Vishrava, out of these five wives, he had eight children from Ilavida. He had Dhan Kuber, that is lord of wealth. Brahmaji has given wealth, or the creator of wealth, task the duty to the Kuberji, that is child of Vishrava and Ilavida. Now from Kaikasi, Vishrava had children: Ravan, Vibhishan, Khara, Kumbhakaran, Dushman, Ahiravan, and Shurpankha. Now, so that means there is a linkage between Kuber and Ravan. Kuberji and Ravan are brothers. Kuberji was the elder brother, Ravan was the younger brother. Vibhishan, Kumbhakaran, all are brothers, and they are from Rakshash Yoni. Now, in later part, what happened that though there is a relation with, they are from the same family, Kuberji and Ravan, but then Kuberji was the king. Earlier, Kuberji was the king of Lanka. But then, what happened? Let's see. So, Kuberji and Ravan, they both have brother from the same father, and their father was Vishrava. And Vishrava was son of Pulatsya. And again, Pulatsya was son of Brahmaji, created by Vishnu. So, Ravan and Kuber, both have brother, but from different mother. And there was also a story that the Pushpak Viman, which Ravan was having, and on this Pushpak Viman Ravan can move to any part of this world was actually believed that the Pushpak Viman was created by Kubirji. But Kubirji was lord of wealth. He has to take care about wealth. Then how come Kubirji was having this Pushpak Viman? So as per Hindu mythology, there was a book called, or there is Shastra called Viman Shastra, how to create Viman. Viman means aeroplane which we are going right now, and which was created by Rishi Bhardwaj. And now there is a link with Rishi Bhardwaj and Kubirji, right? So Kubirji is actually grandson of Rishi Bhardwaj, because Ilavida is the daughter of Rishi Bhardwaj, right? And Kubirji is a son of Ilavida. So that might be possible that the Pushpak Viman was actually inspiration, or you can say creation of Rishi Bhardwaj, because he has created the Viman Shastra. Then it was owned by Kubirji, who was creator of wealth, or you can say lord of wealth. But then after some year, Ravan has taken away the empire of Sri Lanka from Kubirji, and then he became the king of Lanka. It was also believed in Hindu mythology that during this 14 years of Vanvas, the first meeting, that means just after moving from Ayodhya, Ramji, Sitaji and Lakshmanji, they have crossed the river Ganga, Saryu Nadi, and they first met with the Rishi, and his name was Rishi Bhardwaj. So there is a linkage with Sri Lanka, Ravan, Rishi Bhardwaj, Kubirji. Rishi Bhardwaj, the Sri Lanka is actually the place where Rishi Bhardwaj's daughter had married, that means with Vishrava. And then Vishrava had a second child called Kaikasi, and from her Vishrava had son called Ravan. So Rishi Bhardwaj was aware about the place Sri Lanka. That is what we can come to know from the this mythological stories. And he has given, that is Rishi Bhardwaj has given direction to Lord Ram that what can be the 14 year Vanvas, what he can do in this 14 year Vanvas. And that is also believed that after victory against Ravan, Lord Ram has come back to Ayodhya, and Pushpak Viman was gifted by Vibhishan to Lord Rama. And then Lord Ram, Mata Sita and Lakshmanji, they come back to Ayodhya on this Pushpak Viman. So these are some stories, or you can say linkages with this. There is another linkages which we can have. The other Saptarishis are also having linkage with creation of Bharatvarsh, and there is a linkage with Mahabharata also, that maybe I'll try to prepare it in the next video. Thank you very much for the listening, and do visit my blogspot for the other materials. Thank you very much.